Hello and welcome everyone to the first base show-off on our brand new ARK server, hosted and sponsored by Survival Servers. Today we are showing off an amazing build, all done by Sean, and we will also be talking a bit about the server itself, the changes, the mods, and the giveaways. That's right though, he has been building like crazy for the past few days, and he's made something truly amazing. For you to come in, have a look, come and have some fun on the server, as well as also something for the newcomers to actually help them out eventually will be built as well, so I am told. Is that right, Sean? Is there something cool, amazing coming soon for the newcomers?
Yes, we're actually going to be building a village just outside of this complex, which newcomers will be able to hang around in and use the resources in, simply so they don't have to go out and face the harsh reality of ARK straight away. They will have the possibility of, if you like, camping in this village, so it gives them a safe zone, if you like.
Very awesome. So yes, we actually have changed the service sort of, what are they called, stats in a way, statistics, if you're rates, that's it, rates. We've changed the rates to become quite a lot harder than normal servers. And for that, quite a lot of newcomers are a little bit deterred. However, if they get into this village where Sean is going to be building it, I will probably help him a little bit as well. But yes, if you come into this village, it kind of gives you a bit of a stepping stone into the game, into our particular server, and gets you going. So, firstly though, let's start with Sean's build and we can talk a bit more about the potential changes coming up in the future. So, Sean, what is the first building we'll be going through today?
The first building is the warehouse, which we've been using for storage. But it does also house our fabricators and smithies and a few dinosaurs.
Just a few, but there's also one checking out the door.
Yes, I didn't realize he was there. Give me a bit of a fright.
I shall ask. Am I allowed to pass? I do not care. Stay away, T-Rex, or wherever you are.
That's a Giga.
Well, that's a Giga. Whoa, that is one big ass dinosaur.
The Horde symbol painted on its leg.
Ooh, let's have a look at this. Let's have a look.
See it from here.
Aha, yes, I can see it. Did you color that in yourself?
No, Anna did it.
Anna? Ooh. Thank you very much, Anna. That it does look amazing. I do believe I'll have to get her to do that on mine.
There's also a station where you can hatch eggs. Use them the right temperature.
Cool. Let's have a look at these. Let's have a little. Can I open these?
Oops.
They're air cons. Oh, they're just air conditionings. Oh, so you put an egg in the middle? Is that right?
Indeed, yes.
Ah, right, okay. I haven't seen the sort of hatching yet, so you need air conditioning units to actually hatch eggs and stuff like that?
Right. Well, basically, it either tells you if it's too hot or too cold, and you kind of use torches, for example, to change the temperature, although these generally keep it the perfect temperature.
Very useful. Well, there you go, guys. You know what you need, a shitload of cables and some air conditioning units to hatch those pesky little eggs. And what is this little thing? I believe this is a little generator, I believe, yes?
Indeed. This powers both the air conditioning units and both of the lifts, which take you upstairs to the storage.
Ooh. Check those. Oh, this is a lift here.
So I'm going to use that one. I'm going to use this one.
Ah, speed. One each. Ah, it's a race. I'm winning. Get off.
Watch the tail.
Swish. Ooh, lots of storage. Yeah, definitely a warehouse.
Storing everything.
Yes, you'll be very busy. Very busy, man. Hey, get away, dinosaur. This is our ledge.
What are you looking at?
Oh, look at that dragon. That is right, guys. That is right. We'll be talking a bit more about this later, but we do have dragons. We have got a mod that allows dragons. But don't worry. You can see the awesome, amazing dragon there, but we'll talk a little bit more about mods later.
Oh, yes.
What else have we got? Loads and loads of windows.
Sorted everything. So in this chest, you've got saddles. In these
far
chests,
right.
We'll have... Yep, far right, we've got saddles. And in these chests, we will have armor. Just put some in that one for now. In these chests, we'll have weapons. In these chests, we'll have oil, for some reason. Like miscellaneous, I suppose. In this one, we've got recipes. So it's all sorted.
Oh. I do like the look of that medical brew. Mm. And on the other side, same thing?
On the other side, they're all empty, but yeah, same design.
Eventually. One of these days, they'll be full of stuff.
You actually see if there's ledges above each door, which I'm tempted to build a ladder up to. I don't know if they serve any purpose.
They're stork ledges.
Oh, yes, we'll keep the dodos in there.
Yes. That's those little pesky dodos. Ah, tail. Ah, run away. You guys trying to swish me. Oh, here we go. Here's all the fabricators and stuff. Here are special little weapons. Ooh, lots of metal.
That's all of our metal. In the next one, we have a lot of resources.
Ooh, electronics and polymer. I do believe I shall be raiding this place soon.
This is ours. This is a blueprint.
Yes.
These, again, a lot more materials. And then the first chest to your left has oil, gasoline in it. The other one has nothing in it yet.
Need that pesky gasoline to power everything. And so, how long has this sort of warehouse taken you to actually make? Is it sort of just a couple of days, an entire day, half a day?
Actually, I start doing it on my day off, I think. And then I ended up having it done by that night, so it took a day.
Mm-hmm. Very cool. And yes, that is right, guys. You did not misread. That does say this is called the Massive Horn. There it is. Yes, Sean loves his innuendo names. Destroyer of Worlds. Very cool. Smaug. Even though he's wrong colouring, he looked bitchy. Look at that. Oh, white with gold wings. Moist Beaver. Yes, that is correct. Moist Beaver. Very cool dinos. Have you tamed all these yourself?
Pretty much. I'm pretty sure I tamed all of these ones. Yep.
Oh, no. I did this one for you, though.
Do you want to know why this is called Sonic?
Ooh, yes, show.
Look to your right a little bit. And you'll see.
I was expecting him to jump up and grab that little gold star above your head.
Yeah, well, he is called Sonic because he spins and he's blue.
Oh, yes, that's a Dodicarus, isn't it?
It is, yes.
Very awesome, very awesome. Forrest Gump is a massive Bronto.
It's not a Bronto, actually.
Oh, is that? What is this?
It's a Diplodocus.
Oh, this is that new one. Sorry. Oh, this is that new one.
It is, indeed.
Wait a minute, is that a saddle? What is that? Why is that on top?
Actually seats 11 people, including the driver.
What? It's like a bus. Fucking ARK bus. Ooh, yeah, stay away from that. But yes. So 11 people plus you, so that's 12 people in total. 12? I think the last biggest dino.
You got one at the front, the driver, and then you've got 5 on each side, so 11.
Oh, 11 altogether. Ah, got you. Awesome. Well, you know, he'll be a very busy man with our awesome newcomers. We'll
actually
show them around.
If you come to the dinosaur and you hold down E, look at all the different options.
What?
Yep. Look at the
boarding.
Look at the bottom. Look at the very bottom where it says access inventory. Just left of that, enable public seating. You can have it so anybody can get on. Anybody at all.
I do believe this is going to be an amazing attraction called Dino Ride.
It's basically a bus.
Yes, it is. It is definitely a bus, a tram, a train, essentially a dino-powered getaway vehicle, which will go very slow.
However, if I just reverse the clock, it's too big.
Reverse. Reversing.
If I turn this around and then reverse it as much as possible, it's probably not very much. Just have a look how he runs. So get back a bit and you'll see.
Ooh.
Get back a bit.
Like a dog.
Now do you see why I called it Forrest Gump?
Oh my god.
Have a look at this.
It is pretty damn quick to say it's a massive animal like that.
Oh yes. Do you want to know the interesting thing though? This is how it attacks.
A little flick of the neck.
Flick of the neck.
He
has a lot of swag.
You got a lot of pull with the ladies. Not with those teeth, though. No. Anyway. Right. I do believe you should park your animal, and then we can move on to the next building, because those dinos are epic. And, I can't move. Why can't I move? Making the ground shake. Stop making the ground shake. There we go. Awesome. Yes, guys. On to the next building. Now, as you can see, Sean has gone for the realistic look. Awesome stone foundations throughout with wood everywhere else and reinforced windows and doors. Same here with thatch roofing, of course. What else? So Sean, what is this amazing building over there? What is this one?
This is essentially, it's designed in the same way as a Viking long haul. If you come inside, you will see the design really for practical use, more for function.
As in parties?
Oh yes, hell yes.
Oh yes, definitely. Indeed.
And well, we do have some barrels of beer upstairs and drums.
We'll definitely play some drums later, definitely. We'll have some fun with those drums. And beer. And both together, of course. With these amazing T-Rex heads, I believe. Yes, I've got T-Rexes. And how long is this one?
Yes.
Alpha T-Rexes?
Yes.
What makes them alpha? What's different?
Alpha T-Rexes have... Well, I hear that they have around roughly 10 times the stats as a normal T-Rex at that level.
They
glow red like demons.
I've seen some glowing red ones. I've seen some glowing red ones. And they are very scary. And this build... yeah. And this build, how long did this one take you compared to the big warehouse?
I think... Around the same time, actually. I think this may have actually taken me less time, but we did make some improvements the day, like a day or two afterwards as well. So if you want to include improvements into the whole process, maybe, you know, 1 to 3 days.
Yeah, this one definitely has more detail. It's got torches, it's got chairs, it's got tables, got the awesome head-mounted T-Rex skulls, chimneys, and of course the epic LS sign. Look at that. And then some drums. Anna's suggestion. Yes, she definitely knows what she wants. Definitely know what she wants. Is that Anna? Yeah, it's Anna. Yeah, she loves the drums. She falls asleep at the drums and then she goes offline.
Oh, cover up.
That's what she does. I'm guessing there's some back rooms because I see loads of doors. I'm guessing there's back rooms. More storage. Very cool. Ooh, painted doors. Very nice. Good.
That's probably all of the doors in that style. It's basically like a golden frame. We've got a metal frame with black paint on the doors.
Ah, a very nice colour. Ooh, got some massive industrial grills and some cooking pots. You can't go wrong with a cooking pot. An industrial grill's nice, but you need that extra little bit of flavour with the cooking pot. Ooh, so beds and stuff, so sort of keep all the trusty customers. Or just to spawn here for yourself, you know. Whichever way you want to do it, roleplay.
Any people in the tribe can spawn here, but...
Roleplay, that's all. Roleplay.
You can pretend to wake up in
there. Ah, there's roof access now. Very awesome. Here we go. Back to
this. This roof is better than it looks from down here. If you saw it from outside, it looks amazing.
We'll definitely have a look. Yes, we shall definitely have a look at that. Oh. That dragon wing is definitely clipping through that wall, but not to worry, guys. We'll just pretend it's not there. Yes. Wood everywhere. Torches everywhere. Some random crate with spyglass.
Oh, yes. Basically, if someone doesn't have a spyglass and they're up here and they're scouting out for us, they can just grab the spyglass out of that, chuck it on your hotbar, use it. When they're finished with it, chuck it back in.
Yes, just like I'm demonstrating right now. Look at this. Ah, the sun! Ah, sun's in my eyes.
The sun is level 5,000!
Yes, wait till noon and it's over 9,000! Ooh, a dodo. 25. Pff, rubbish.
eat you for breakfast.
So I believe this is the last main building. What else is around this base? What else have you been doing up to? I've seen some walls and some spikes. What else is
the
about?
The front walls were done very, very early on wood, I believe, and then we upgraded them to stone, and then upgraded them to metal. Now the back wall over there is quite recent. I basically mixed the front wall with that one. So it's not got a ramp going up there just yet. I actually didn't think about that until just now.
Would be useful.
Oh yes. And then on this side we've got spike walls going all the way around up until the tap room. Which has a tap in it.
Does it now? I've never guessed for the name of that.
No, well, yeah, it's not an inappropriate room. There's a tap in it.
Let's have a look at this tap.
It literally sticks right through the wall. No cutting needed.
Actually, you could have wet t-shirt parties in here, man. Wet t-shirt.
Oh, yes.
Whey.
And if we just bring in a bit of dirt, mud wrestling.
Yes, guys. I forgot to show you. This is my monkey. He's called Saiyan. Oh, baby Saiyan. It's cool. He's just along for the shower, that's all. There you go. Yeah.
Anyway. I'll take you to it.
No, come back. Gotta show me more of your build. I'm nothing clean now, but I'm not keeping the chat clean. That's okay.
Oh, there's actually something over here I can show you.
Ooh.
And that is the inside of the walls. Now, on both sides, left and right, there's a door up this ramp. And
to the outside.
Oh, looking outside.
Oh no, I'm just looking at the view.
Door goes outside.
But yes, guys, we actually chose an amazing place to start. Amazing views, amazing location, lots of materials, lots of awesome animals. Ah, another monkey. There's your friend, but you can't have him. Just go. With further up, Sean. How far does it go up, Sean? Tell me.
That's the side that goes up.
Oh. Cool though, because I can shoot. Shoot from here. Let's see if we can shoot this mole. Whatever it is. What is this thing called? This mole thing with the tusks?
This name's too long to remember.
Yeah.
A mole and a dog.
I shot him, but he ran away. And I don't think I can shoot him now. Nope. Oh, that's base. I failed, I'm sorry. There's no meat for tea. There's no meat for tea.
There's these doors. Yes. And then the other door. Up here.
Oh, there's another door? Oh my god.
Oh, close the doors behind you, John. Do not want people calling you Sam now.
I was busy showing people things. More spikiness.
Keep going.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Metal corridor. Fucking Tetris.
Another door here. That leads to the old base, our first landing, if you like, of this place.
Yep, that's right, guys. He is called I Smash on the First Date.
Oh, we've got two of those now.
What about the. Okay. You got to match the name of male and female. Yeah. We need Ice Smash on a second date though. Next,
this space is actually disgraced. Look at it.
Yeah, I believe this was your first initial base that you started.
I will have it on the record that Anna built this one.
Actually, it's not on record. It's fucking proof. Look at that, personal owner Anna. Fail.
Yeah.
Run away. And this monstrosity of a base. Up there. Look at this. Bash and wood.
Dunk the dunk players down here.
Petrol pump. There you are.
See, is he starving? Nope, not yet. Interesting. Let's put his weight up. I'm sure he's got plenty of weight for carrying all that heavy stuff around. Oh, he's leveled up a few times. Oh my.
He's almost at 169, wait. Almost there.
Close to two.
So, Is there anything else that we haven't seen yet? About your... Oh, actually, we haven't seen the Watchtower. Oh, yeah, the Watchtower. Now, this guy's... Oh, son. This guy's was the first thing I saw when John was building. This is the first thing that I sighted, I'm pretty sure. This is an amazing looking Watchtower.
You may as well show these spike walls while we're up here.
Oh, yeah, this is Sean's maze of amazing spikes. Now, this, guys and girls, is essentially... I can't see it.
Nothing has breached our spike walls. Nothing, I say.
Yeah, essentially, he's made a very secretive way through these spikes. No one knows apart from the tribe members, and you can never know unless you get into our tribe. Essentially, dinos get killed by it. You can get through it somehow if you know the way, and we can essentially trap people, which is awesome.
It's climb.
No.
This tower is awesome. I actually want to make a tower identical to this on the inside.
Loving the youth, man. Pillars, epic. Roof, epic. And it's definitely like a continental house. Blinding light. Yeah, where did you fall down?
Yeah, you pushed me off.
Well, you know, that's what happens when... Oh, there you are. That's what happens when you get near me. You get pushed off. But yes, there's the other view. Look at that. Look at that amazing view. Even though you're getting blinded, don't worry. It's just because it's an amazing view and you have to put up with it.
Start using a couple of commands. R.blue quality space zero and R.light shaft space zero when I'm streaming, and it certainly gets rid of the blindingness.
Ooh. There you go, guys. A very nice little tip there. I'll be using that because it is bloody light here. It's super light.
Right, so we've come up there because I've started using auto torch to place torches for decoration and lighting, and I will be placing some up in this tower.
Ah, yes. I believe, seeing that we're on to the last area with the wall and the door here. Look at this amazing door. So changes, mods. If you want to let us know, which mods have you added so far and what do they do?
Okay, so first of all, the very first mod we added, because of course we could not do this. Double negative, kind of. Come back down.
I am on my way.
Oh, I'll come back up.
I'm independent with the lift operating.
The first mod that we added, because we simply couldn't avoid it, was dragons. Small dragons mod, which includes
Deathwing Beast.
It's part of the small dragons mod. It's called Deathwing for obvious reasons, based on the badass from World of Warcraft, Deathwing.
And neon green eyes. Look at those bloody eyes.
Oh, yes. We had one called Arthur. Do you want to tell them what happened to Arthur?
Yes, I decided to test to see if I could essentially walk off a cliff with him, and he died.
Yes.
Well, you know, it's the devs. I'm pretty sure before I did that, I said, yeah, the devs have done it right. They've actually made him well because he actually does it all right. And then they fixed that too.
Yeah.
Shush.
The next mod that I installed was Auto Torch. Now we'll have to go back to the Viking long hats.
No one problem at all. We shall have a nice little wander through this little tail here. Hello there, tail.
Might as well paint these doors in the same colours as that one.
That door does look pretty damn badass. And it's in my favourite colours, red and black.
Now, all of the wall torch and the standing torches in this room are from the auto torch mod, which means you do not have an inventory for them. They are always lit.
24/7?
Yeah. Well, there's two different versions of each torch. There is a wall torch and a standing torch, which is always lit. And there's a wall torch and a standing torch which turns on at night and turns off in the morning on a timer.
That's pretty cool. So they're sort of customized, and you can essentially use them for how you want. Oh, chimneys. Chimneys as well?
No, fireplaces have to be lit by us still.
You heard it, modders. Get that to work. Get it to work.
Final mod that we installed is the bridge mod. Now, the closest bridge to us is quite far away. So I don't know how, if you want to show it, but we'll have to fly over there.
If you stay still right now, I'll teleport us here with my special powers. If you wait, 1, 2, 3. No, I'm only joking. Let's get. it says to get something flying, and we'll have a little fly. You're probably quicker. Let me put my phoenix down. Oh yeah, look at this swagger. I have a proper swagger. No. Anyway, onwards. You're not going to drop my monkey, are you? Better not.
No.
I'll close the door. Okay.
Underneath,
and... I'm running away! Glitching.
To be fair, he does have 250% movement speed.
I'm pretty sure this is fucking hyperspeed.
It is. Fish tank.
Hello there, Moses.
He's trying to follow me still. I'm
getting glitched into your arsehole. Stay away.
Oh, God.
There we go. I can see this again.
This is the bridge.
Ah. Put me down, please, Squire. Thank you.
it's actually bigger than I thought. Well, that's the thing. It can be both widened and extended as much as you want. You basically, it has a certain amount of resources to make it. Once you've made it, you can create it as wide and as long as you want. So, of course, it has the ability to be abused, so we will be administrating it very closely to make sure that nobody uses it to get over people's walls, for example, or makes them ridiculously large, or stuck in the air.
You heard it, guys. No cheating. But it does look rather nice. Rather realistic, too. Very nice. So there actually is no limitation on the bridge itself, but so what will actually happen if someone makes something completely ridiculous, or if they try to misuse it, we just decon it, or whoa, how dare you?
Yeah, so we'll deconstruct it, so it will no longer exist if someone makes one that's deemed unsuitable.
And if you manipulate or totally use it multiple times, you shall be punished. No, I'm only joking. well, you might get a slap. It's back. Okay. Whatever floats our boat, really.
Nobody cares about your own boats.
We also, other than mods, what are the changes? We've actually added a couple changes, I believe, to the race recently over to the center map. What are those changes?
I believe I made it so both mating, hatching, and laying speeds, I believe, are quicker. Some of them are 3 times quicker, some of them are 5 times quicker. I can't particularly remember. I think one of them is 5 times quicker, the others are 3. It might be the hatching speed is 5 times quicker, I seem to recall.
Yep.
Did we change anything else?
I think that was mainly it. I think people wanted... essentially,
did we change experience?
I think it was essentially people wanted to be able to mature / lay eggs / hands, all that kind of stuff. So animals and creatures, they wanted that improving, along with what we've already done before with gathering and stuff. And yes, experience. They wanted 3 times experience, which is the other thing. But don't worry, guys. We've got a full list and discussion in Steam. I'll put the link in the description below for you guys to have a little peruse and a little look through, so you guys can know exactly what we have and haven't done. We have changed quite a lot from our original island server compared to this, because we've actually figured out quite a lot. Got to know what people like, as quite a few people are joining now. We'll also put in the description the Connect page. Yes, we have a special little Connect page that you guys can connect to our server, have some fun, tame your own dragon. Who doesn't want their own dragon? And you can essentially come and have fun with us, check out the build. I will be doing other videos in the future for other people's build as well. So if you want to build something awesome, awesome, let me know and I'll come and have a look at the build and we'll make a little YouTube video together. But other than that, we've actually started doing giveaways. Sean, want to let us know about giveaways? What are we doing?
Basically, every time we reach a 100 follower milestone, we have said that we will be giving away a Quetzal. Every time we reached 250 follower milestone, we said we would be giving away a Giga. And every time we reached a 500 follower milestone, we said that we'd be giving away a Dragon. Now, we haven't particularly been reaching those milestones, so we've been discussing the possibility of doing them either weekly or bi-weekly.
Ooh. So giveaways out of a milestone particular area, and also ones that are inside the milestone area as
yes.
well.
Yeah.
Cool. So guys, that is Twitch followers, by the way, guys. Twitch followers, so every 100, every 250, and every 500, they're the milestones we're currently looking into. You can get yourself a Quetzal for every 100. Essentially, one person will win one every time we get to 100 or each 100 milestone. A Giga, every 250 follower milestone on Twitch. And then a Dragon, just like this amazing beast right in front of me. That's the shot. and each one will be level 100. A Dragon every 500 milestone. So, level 100, Quetzal, Giga or Dragon.
This does mean that when we get to 230,500 that we're giving away one of each.
Oh cool, sweet. So it's not just 100, then 250, then 500, then it gets us again. So
well,
each time so
level three, so yeah.
Ah, wicked. So you actually mega giveaway days. Oh, that's gonna be epic day. I can't wait for that first day. First day we're gonna give away everything. That'll be wicked. But yes. In relation to the weekly and bi-weekly, we will be giving you more updates about that. We've only just started discussing it, just to sort of get some cool giveaways, cool creatures to everyone, start improving the overall experience in game. We will be rebuilding as well the PvP arena that we started building and almost finished building in the island server. It's mainly because we've got to sort of get our build itself ready, and then we started thinking about the newcomers, about being it's quite difficult because of the way that we've played the game, but we've got quite a few active members that like it how it is, so we're going to be improving the newcomer game by making the village just outside our area so we can help them and give them something to sort of start with. That's all going on, and then of course any and all changes that you guys want to get implemented, as long as a majority of people want the change, we can look into it. I'm not guaranteeing that we're going to change anything and everything, even if every single person wants it changed. If it can be exploited, it's not going to get done. But if it's advantageous in any way, probably won't get done. Yeah, exactly, Dragon. That's it. Nod that head. Yeah, that's it. Exactly. but essentially, if it's going to improve the overall player experience, it's going to improve the game experience overall, not just for the one person, but for the entire server as a whole, and overall, it's not going to be exploited or can't be or manipulated or anything in any way, then it could probably get done, as long as it doesn't sort of cause any detrimental harm or stress or overstressing on the server itself to
Absolutely.
Sort of cause that. So, I believe we've actually come to the end. So guys, any and all exactly. Any and all links that we've discussed will be in the description below, like I said. All of our social media, Twitch, Facebook, Twitter, Steam, Discord. We're always in Discord. There's always someone in Discord. Sean barely leaves Discord. Apart from when he's got stuff to do, you know. Yeah, everyone needs some downtime. Oh, yes, that's right, Dragon. Even you have downtime too. It's okay. I didn't forget you. It's all right. It's all right. Those eyes. But yes, We are always in there. There's always someone in there. We want you in there too. Come and have a chat. Come and say hi. We don't expect you to come in every day, but if you want to, we're there too. We will always have a chat with you, have some fun. Even get some game together. If everyone wants to play a particular game, we'll have some fun with you. We don't care. Anything, as long as we've got it, we'll have a play. So, Sean, any final words you want to say to the lovely ladies and gentlemen here listening?
No, not really.
How dare you? You see, I have that all nicely planned myself, you know, just it being all nice, and then Sean just comes out and said, nah, not really. No, I'm only joking. It's because I've asked so many questions, he hasn't got anything else to say. That's it, ladies and gentlemen. I've been such a good interviewer. He actually has nothing else to tell you. That's what it is, isn't it, Sean?
Nothing to chance.
Exactly. I made sure of it. I made sure I got rid of any and all questions. But if you guys do have any questions that I've missed or anything at all about the server, our community, future games, anything at all, let us know in the comment sections below. If you have anything you don't want to put in the public forum, then give us an email. Only myself and Sean can access that. Other than that, we're in Discord. Want to come and chat real time? Either text chat, DMs, or in the Hangout, or voice chats. We're usually in one of the channels that you can access too. So, thank you very much for listening, guys, and watching, of course, because this is a video, of course. I believe you can see this amazing dragon right here. We hope to see as many of you in the game, as well as on Discord, Twitch, everywhere else. And we really, really hope you enjoy this video. Thank you very much, guys. Have a good one.
Goodbye.